As Shakespeare loves his heroes and braggarts, so he dwells with equal interest on the weaknesses of mankind. Here is Richard II, a foppish, shallow king with the soul of an artist, who cannot sustain the responsibilities of kingship. He defies his cousin Henry Bolingbroke, who has raised the English nobles in rebellion against him, but finally surrenders his crown to him in a great scene of self-recrimination in Westminster Hall.
We are amazed. And thus long have we stood to watch the fearful bending of thy knee, because we thought ourselves thy lawful king. And if we be, how dare thy joints forget to pay their awful duty to our presence? If we be not, show us the hand of God that hath dismissed us from our stewardship. For well we know, no hand of blood and bone can gripe the sacred handle of our scepter, but that he do profane, steal, or usurp. And though you think that all, as you have done, have torn their souls by turning them from us, and we are barren and bereft of friends, yet know, my master, God omnipotent, is mustering in the clouds on our behalf armies of pestilence, and they shall strike your children, yet unborn and unbegot, that lift your vassal hands against my head and threat the glory of my precious crown. Tell Bolingbroke, for yon methinks he stands, that every step he takes upon my land is dangerous treason. He is come to ope the purple testament of bleeding war. But ere the crown he look for dwell in peace, 10,000 bloody crowns of mother's sons shall ill become the flower of England's face, turn the complexion of her maid pale peace to scarlet indignation, and bedew her pasture's grass with faithful English blood. What must the king do now? Must he submit? The king shall do it. Must he be deposed? The king shall be contented. Must he lose the name of king? Or God's name, let it go. I'll give my jewels for a set of beads, my gorgeous palace for a hermitage, my gay apparel for an almsman's gown, my figured goblets for a dish of wood, my scepter for a palmer's walking staff, my subjects for a pair of carved saints, and my large kingdom for a little grave. A little, little grave, an obscure grave. Or I'll be buried in the king's highway, some way of common trade, where subjects' feet may hourly trample on their sovereign's head. For on my heart they tread whilst now I live, and buried once, why not upon my head? Down, down I come, like glistering Phaethon, wanting the manage of unruly jades, in the base court, where kings grow base, to come a traitor's call and do them grace. In the base court, come down, down court, down king, for night owls shriek, where mounting larks should sing. Alack, why am I sent for to a king, before I have shook off the regal thoughts wherewith I reigned? I hardly yet have learned to insinuate, flatter, bow and bend my knee. Give sorrow leave a while to tutor me to this submission. Yet I well remember the favors of these men. Were they not mine? Did they not sometime cry, all hail to me? So Judas did to Christ, yet he in 12 found truth in all but one. I in 12,000, none. God save the king. Will no man say amen? Am I both priest and clerk? Well then, amen. God save the king, although I be not he. And yet, amen, if heaven do think him me. To do what service am I sent for hither? Give me the crown. Here, cousin, seize the crown. Here, cousin, on this side, my hand, and on that side yours. Now is this golden crown like a deep well that owes two buckets filling one another, the emptier ever dancing in the air, the other down, unseen and full of water. That bucket down and full of tears am I, drinking my griefs, whilst you mount up on high. Now mark me, how I will undo myself. I give this heavy weight from off my head, and this unwieldy scepter from my hand, the pride of kingly sway from out my heart. With mine own tears I wash away my balm, with mine own hands I give away my crown, with mine own tongue deny my sacred state, with mine own breath release all duteous oaths. All pomp and majesty I do forswear, my manors, rents, revenues I forego, my acts, decrees, and statutes I deny. God pardon all oaths that are broke to me. God keep all oaths unbroke are made to thee. Make me that nothing have, with nothing grieved, and thou with all pleased that hast all achieved. Long mayst thou live in Richard's seat to sit, and soon lie, Richard, in an earthy pit. God save King Harry! Unkinged Richard says, and send him many years of sunshine days. Nay, all of you that stand and look upon, whilst that my misery doth bate myself, though some of you with Pilate wash your hands, showing an outward pity, yet you Pilates have here delivered me to my sour cross, and water cannot wash away your sin. Oh, that I were a mockery king of snow, standing before the sun of Bolingbroke, to melt myself away in water drops. Good king, great king, and yet not greatly good. And if my word be sterling yet in England, let it command a mirror hither straight, that it may show me what a face I have, since it is bankrupt of his majesty. Give me the glass, and therein will I read. No deeper wrinkles yet. Hath sorrow struck so many blows upon this face of mine, and left no deeper wounds? Oh, flattering glass! Like to my followers in prosperity, thou dost beguile me. Was this face the face that every day under his household roof did keep 10,000 men? Was this the face that, like the sun, did make beholders wink? Was this the face that faced so many follies, that was at last outfaced by Bolingbroke? A brittle glory shineth in this face, as brittle as the glory is the face. For there it lies, cracked in 100 shivers. Mark, silent king, the moral of this sport. How soon my sorrow hath destroyed my face.